Blog Talk Radio.
Are you tired of the same old radio?
Sure am.
Need an outlet to show who you are?
Oh yeah.
You want to hear great TV reviews and original shows?
Sounds good.
Or just new ways to keep up on the Jags?
Let's go Jags! Woo, woo, woo!
Join us on Teal Time Radio.
The station that matters.
Cause you matter.
Well, welcome to Teal Time Radio. I hope everybody likes our new ad. It's a lot shorter.
And it's real cute.
This is CG Jags, joined me by the beautiful Miss Chrissy.
Hey, everybody.
Alongside our other co-host over here, Mr. Poppy Redhorner.
Yep.
Hello.
Welcome, Poppy.
Hello, everybody.
You sound so enthusiastic today.
I know, really.
Before we get started with the show, we're going to let everyone know that we are doing business cards this weekend to pump up the audience more than it's already there. Thank you for all our loyal listeners and supporters and everything. We have a lot of things greatly planned, such as great interviews.
A lot of different up-and-coming unsigned bands.
Yeah, and just because they're unsigned don't mean they're not good or great.
Of course.
They're phenomenal, in my opinion.
And everybody deserves a chance, you know? And, I mean, we'll still do our Lizard Lick and our South Beach Toe and, you know, all the usual, our happy hour. And
our
do the dang thing. There you go.
Okay, and this show is called X-Censored. It's a show that's a little edgier and a little less, I don't know.
Yeah, there you go.
But here's our first topic of the night. We're going to talk about, let's get the most important one out of the way right away. We're going to talk about doctors and how they are so big-headed when it comes to giving out medicine. I just can't believe all the things, me lately, which is no, you know, like people don't already know. You know, I was in the hospital twice for pancreatitis and whatnot.
And that's very painful if you don't know.
I guess I had some bad vodka or whatever the case may have been.
Right.
Okay, and, I'm admitted in the hospital. They're willing to give me medication in the hospital. But when they take me out, they treat me like I'm, you know, on a different league, like I'm a sweet corner druggie and whatnot.
Oh, like you're just there to get drugs.
Yeah, exactly.
I went there for pain in my shoulder because I had fallen and actually had hurt my shoulder. And they said to me I had sprained my shoulder. What did they say I did? No, I fractured it. And I went there to get medication for it because it really hurt and to get something for it to help the pain. And they looked at me like I did it all the time.
And now we could easily say, well, this is just up north doctors, but What do you say about down south? Do you say they're about the same or no?
Down south is about the same. They give you the generic drugs, you know, and they actually make you sicker than what you really are. And as far as, you know, it is a lot of pill-head people around. I have to hate to say it like that, but it is. And they treat all people, which is not like that, the same way. And I don't like it at all. They treat the
people that are actually going into pain like corporal tunnel. We're losing you, man. What's going on?
Like the corporal tunnel. And can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Okay, like corporal tunnel and pancreatitis like you have and arthritis, it hurts. But they give you these generic medicine that actually make you sicker than the real thing does, you know?
Yeah, we're not even getting generic. We're getting nothing.
And that's not good.
I mean, I went to a GI doctor today, and they did give me something, finally.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, why should you go to the emergency room where they're supposed to help, and they turn around and, you know, just degrade you? I don't understand that.
Yes, that's what they do here. They do the same exact thing here.
But yet, if I went in there for, you know, if if I had a narcotics problem, no disrespect to those that, you know, do.
Right.
Or,
right.
You know, it was a, you know, a big-time alky, I could get all the drugs in the world. But because I work and everything, and, you know, I'm not, I'm treated like a lowlife. It's ridiculous.
Yes, it is. It really is. And you, and what's really crazy about it, you are actually in pain, and they won't give you nothing for it.
Yeah, if they admit you, they'll give you something for it, but the minute they let you go, forget about you.
Oh, then they don't care about you. They don't want to hear about you.
Right.
Oh, you got pain? Oh, too bad.
Yeah.
And then, God forbid, if you go back the second time in the same week, they automatically think, well, it's something that, you know, you weren't on your low-fat diet or you weren't doing this right or doing that right, and that's why you're
right.
here when that's not the case.
Or you're back for pills.
Right.
You're just there for pills. No, you're in serious pain because you really have an injury or an illness or whatever, and that's how they treat you.
Yeah.
It's an absolute disgrace that doctors
yeah.
would treat people this way.
I agree.
Now, once
yes,
again, my
is.
Doctor today was very cool.
Yes,
but,
he was.
But they come, they're far and few.
Very rare.
Yeah, they're far and few between.
Exactly, very rare.
Yeah.
This man young, and he was just a real young, hip doctor. He was really good.
And he said that, you know, I actually listen to the patients, and when the patients tell me they're in pain, I try to help them out.
Yeah,
right.
He says, and if I don't, you know, if they're still in pain, then it's my fault for not listening, if I don't listen
right.
to them. So I thought that was cool.
That was real
yeah.
cool.
I mean, you get the bad doctors, which really don't care about you. And you get
true.
Some good doctors. That's true.
But it's mostly bad. I'm sorry, it is.
Yeah.
I mean, I hate to say it like that, but it is.
It is. Half the doctors out there, they get rich and they don't care about you. Oh, we got
yeah.
all the money in the world. We forget what it was like to be you. Because at one time,
yeah.
they all started out like us. Because when they're going to school.
Yes,
not all of them.
No, not all of them, but I'm saying some of them, those that do.
Yeah.
Is what I'm saying. But when they go to medical school, they're working a job, plus they're going to school. And sometimes they're working two jobs, depending on whether,
yeah.
you know, they pay for their own their own schooling or whatever, you know? And there's a lot of ones that do that. But they forget once they start making that money what they used to be.
Yeah, and when
right.
the doctors are like, all right, well, you do this and you do that, they don't understand it costs money. It's just
yeah.
like they always tell me to quit smoking, but who's giving me things to quit smoking?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, who's giving them money
yeah.
to go get a low-fat diet?
No one. I'm just supposed to, you know, come up with this money out of thin air, even though I got a family.
Yeah. I want to know where we're going to get it from. I guess between our toes.
It's the money tree outside. Did you
oh,
not forget
yeah.
to grab it?
I forgot about the money tree. I forgot all about it.
Yeah. No,
yeah.
Whatever.
I forgot to water it.
Exactly. Okay, next up, we're going to talk about privacy laws. What do you think is legitimate as far as how far they can actually go where it becomes a problem?
Well, see, I think when it comes to privacy, companies and doctors shouldn't be able to get out any information on any patient or any employee or anybody that they have anything to do with their company unless that person signs a waiver saying that that person can be given information or that company or whatever, that doctor or whoever.
Well, I mean, with doctors, you have the HIPAA policy, so
right.
you're basically, you know,
covered. But I'm saying, but with anything.
Right.
If the person doesn't sign a waiver saying that they want to give out their information, then you shouldn't be able to. What do you think,
right.
Poppy?
I agree with you. I mean, it's when it's, you know, I understand about the HIPAA policy that doctors do have, but as you know, when you go to a certain hospital here in where I'm at. They get you to sign papers if you want anybody to actually know where you are. I mean, most hospitals don't do that. You know what I mean? And that's where I feel like the policy comes, the law the law privacy should come in at is if you want people to visit you, you know what I mean, or certain people to visit you, you put it down on the list. And
exactly, yeah, like today when we went to the doctor's office, they asked Ray, well, in case of emergency, who do you want to be notified? And he put down who he wanted to be notified.
Right.
You know, I mean, that's just how it is, and that's all that the only person I can know would be me, because I'm the one he put down.
Yeah.
But, I mean,
like I said, some hospitals here don't even ask you that. They really don't care if anybody that, you know what I mean, that you don't want in your room, or if you admit it, somebody you don't want in your room, they really don't care, you know?
Exactly.
And,
but let's go beyond just, like, doctors, per se.
Right.
And let's just say, in general.
Especially, like, companies.
Well, yeah, companies is very, very true.
They like to give out your information, certain companies, not all.
Correct.
But certain ones. Yeah. And, you know, how do you feel about that, Poppy?
I feel like the employer that I was working at before I got this one, she would not allow it. She did not tell anybody that the employee was there. And I liked it. But most companies is not like that. You know what I mean? As far as companies giving away, like your private information as far as how you work and stuff like that, I agree with that to a point. You know, but But as far as companies giving out information, I mean, it could help you and it could hurt you. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
It could help you and it could hurt you because.
And I mean, it spans beyond that realm. If you go to the internet realm,
right?
There's
right.
a lot of sites out there that purposely, or you know, through their small print.
Uh-huh.
You know, that you can't understand, that's in only lawyer talk, you give them permission without realizing you give them permission.
Exactly.
And it's unfair that they're unclear of what
their expectations are.
Yeah, and what they're actually trying to achieve.
Exactly.
Now, as far as that certain site that I hardly ever go on, as far as giving away locations and stuff like that, I don't like it. I disagree with that, you know, because it gives away your exact location if you post on their site, it gives away your exact location.
Exactly. It gives away your exact location. And there's, you know, certain sites, and that's beyond, you know, just social media that do even worse. But, I mean, this has been going on forever now, and when is exactly enough? Because if you think about, well, how exactly do telemarketers get your information?
Exactly.
Right.
They buy a list that had nothing to do with them. To call people about things that they have no idea that they need or want.
Exactly. Yeah.
And you know, as far as the telemarketers, this is what I cannot stand. They give you a website to go to, and they you put your name on this website, and it's supposed to stop all of that. The calling in, the pop-ups on your computer. It's supposed to stop all of that. But does it actually stop it? No, it doesn't.
Of course not.
You know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yeah, because it only brings up more surveys. I know exactly
yes.
where you're going with that.
It actually doesn't stop it. And
I don't understand.
Said,
if you want to get rid of pop-ups, you got to take this survey. Or you got to click here. And then it opens another box. And then you got to click here. And open about 50 other boxes.
And then you get 15 to 20 calls a week from telemarketers, and it doesn't stop, you know? I'm not understanding that.
Well, I love when the telemarketers call about homeowners. I'm like, yeah, like that really applies to me right now.
I know, really.
You know?
Oh no, what I like to do is when they call, a telemarketer will call the house, and I'll answer the phone, and I'll go, "Hello, Yale Gynecology." They'll go, "What?" I said, "Yale Gynecology." I'm trying to keep a straight face without laughing. And they're like, "Oh, I'm sorry, I have the wrong number." And I hang up and start cracking up. I'm like,
yeah.
"You stupid telemarketer."
I love the educational ones. It asked you, "Would you like to go back to college? It's free on us."
Yeah,
say,
free,
really?
Free.
You're going, yeah, my ass. My tail.
Yeah, it's free attached to a bunch of bills.
Exactly.
I said it. It was one couple of times. I said, "Yes, it's free for you to call." And that's all I get, free for you to call. But thank you.
Yeah.
No thanks.
It's buy here, pay later.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's basically what it is. It's like another form of a credit card.
Exactly.
That's all it is.
For people who can't get credit cards. You know?
Yeah. And then
that's exactly what it is.
The ones that say you're pre-approved for a brand new car. Okay.
But exactly. When is it enough? I mean, they've got, you know, electronic devices on, you know, the beaches now, and you know, where certain people could, if you go through a red light, which is understandable, if you go through a red light, then you deserve to be caught, I guess. You know, but if you go through a red light, they mail you tickets now. I mean, it's just getting to the point where when is enough enough? When is it becoming an invasion of your privacy?
Right. Interstate. It's bad down here, so interstates. That's enough. Come on now. And you can go on a certain website and actually look at this interstate going up through where I'm at. And when, that's what I'm saying, when is enough enough? I mean, that's invading our privacy. When you ride up the interstate, and you have to look, you can look at cameras to see your car going up to interstate.
Yeah, exactly. I loved when I was going through Virginia, and it says this interstate is guarded by air.
Oh yeah.
Air control or something like that.
Yeah, something like that. I was like, okay.
Protected by aircraft, and I'm like, all right, come on, helicopter, let's go. You know?
Yeah, that was wild too. I seen that as we were coming up to visit and stay for a while, and I couldn't believe it.
It was crazy, I'm telling you.
That is the funniest sight I've ever seen. I mean, no disrespect to anybody out in Virginia and whatnot. I know what it means is they watch from the sky and they call in, you know, the local police force or whatever there, highway patrol.
Well, you were just having fun with it because, you know, as a joke, because we were just kind of driving.
We're driving by.
We had a long drive, and it was just something to make us laugh.
Exactly.
And forget about how long it had been.
Exactly, but it was just funny as
anything.
Yeah.
You know, but I mean, honestly, when is enough enough? When are we going to say, no, you can't do that? I mean.
Right.
It could be soon.
This is the question. Can we say it? That's the deal. I don't think we have any control over it. Because when they voted for cameras to be on the interstate, I mean, that's what they got, you know.
Exactly, but I'm not big on websites, you know, taking all my information. Not that I got anything to hide. I'm just not big on it.
No, they don't need to know our business, everything about us, you know?
You know, when I worked for this one company, one of the security questions we had to ask, because we're calling business, is and people took it as a joke, but we're asking people, what color are your eyes? And I'm like, and I'm thinking to myself, what is we need to know what color somebody's eyes are?
Really?
Right.
Like, you're going to know if they're telling the truth. Your eyes could be green, and you could say, oh, my eyes are blue.
But, I mean...
Really?
Well, I guess it's all catch somebody off guard, you know, type question.
Maybe.
Most people will be honest and whatnot. But, I mean, there has to be a point where enough is enough.
Exactly.
What point that is, I don't know. Which brings me to the next question I have, in case they actually shut us off in 30, which they normally don't, but just in case they did. The next-gen systems, I know you've seen them both the PS4 and the Xbox. Well, you haven't seen the PS4. No one's seen the PS4.
Yeah, I was going to say, how are you going to see it?
We've heard about it. We have not seen a system, but...
It's invisible.
Okay, and then there's the Xbox One. We have seen the system, but we don't know if it's got any games.
Exactly.
Just to put it...
I think it's invisible. And I don't know if it even exists. Sometimes I start to wonder.
But anyway, you know, everybody's yelling about the, you know, privacy laws and, you know, in regard to that. We'll start with the Xbox One. You need to have the Kinect hooked to your system 24/7. It has to be hooked on. No one's saying whether it has to be pointed at you or not. But there has been some discrepancies on that. I'm not a fan of that. I really just want to put a paper bag over it.
Well, from what I saw when I looked at it, it looked like it was already built into the system, unless I'm wrong.
Well, it's kind of like the Wii originally was, you know, where it's attached. Somehow it's attached, and it has to plug into the system.
Mm-hmm.
But I have, you know, a few concerns with that. Like I said, I'd like to put a paper back over it or a double bag or something. But that's just because I don't like something looking at me every 2 seconds, whether it's, you know, collecting data or not. Data's not cool, but at the same time, you know, it's not going to harm me. I'm not doing anything stupid.
Exactly.
Right.
What's your take on that?
I think a lot of both of them are getting away from the gaming and going into more of the aspects of the TV, you know. And I think, like I said, I don't think I'll get either of the systems right now until I really see the comments on them.
I'm at that stance on one end. On the other, it is cool for fantasy football and whatnot. And I understand what they're trying to do, but I'm just wondering if there is a hidden meaning behind it.
Yeah, you got to wonder. I mean, I don't blame you.
Right.
And the whole used games, well, here's my theory on that. Everybody's, you know, complaining about the youth games, going over your friend's house, letting somebody borrow it. But let's be honest here. How many times have you let somebody borrow a game and then you try to get your game back and it's all cracked or broken, or they all of a sudden lost it, or they don't want to talk to you anymore because they want to keep the game?
Oh, they just claim that it's their game. Oh, no, that's my game. I had that game. And you know very well that was their game.
You know what I'm saying, man?
Yeah, I know exactly what you're saying. I mean, it's I don't know, man. I can't comment on it because this is what I really want to know, because when I looked at the videos on the Xbox One, they said they're gonna be running off of some type of network. What network was that? That's what I don't understand.
Well, I mean, they're going to be running off the cloud network, which is now going to have, like, 300,000 servers or whatever.
Oh, okay. Does that supposed to make it better, or?
Yeah, it's supposed to, supposedly, the rumor is it's supposed to increase the gameplay because it gives developers more to work with and everything of that, yada, yada, yada. I'm not going to believe it until I actually see it. And another problem I have with it, it's got a 500 gig hard drive, but it's not removable. Yes, you can get an external hard drive, but who really wants to hook another hard drive to it?
Right.
So that's the issue I have on that. On the other end, the people that are talking about the used game market, my theory with the whole used game market, real quick, is if I bring it over to a friend's house, that's fine. If I'm, you know, logged in my account, that's fine. If I let somebody borrow it, that's fine. If they don't give it back to me, I'm mad about it, but that's fine. As long as there's some way, because it was already installed on my system, that I can still play on the system. If it's just it gets wiped off my system, well, I just wasted money.
Right.
Whether they have to pay for money or not doesn't mean anything, because when I try to reinstall the game, it's only going to charge me again. That's even if it's $5, $1, whatever, I feel that's an invasion of my privacy.
Right.
Okay, on the other end.
Okay,
go ahead.
So you're saying, what you're saying is on the used game thing, I mean, I'm not understanding how the used games is going to go on the Xbox.
I don't know. I'm just saying, even on new games, if I bring it to your house, I'm logged in. But if I forget it over your house, I can't play it at my house, and you have to pay for it. That don't make no sense.
There's no more recovery.
I don't know. I do know on the other end, though, for those that are knocking the Xbox One with the PlayStation. A lot of them don't know that Sony does have a patent out that they can block used games, period, if they wanted to, at any point.
Right.
Okay, that's
exactly what I thought they were going to do on the Xbox.
Block it all and just go digital, right?
Yes. Now, that's what I really thought they were going to do.
No, they're not going to do that, because it would make no sense. It really would make no sense.
Right.
But for the, you know, Sony ones, if Microsoft is doing that and they are making a killing off, you know, other people making, you know, $60 a game or whatever, if Sony's not making that money and the developers are going to Xbox, Sony will shut down the used game market, or whatever publishers aren't doing well, they will shut it down. I'm sorry, they will.
That's just how it is.
They don't have that patent for nothing. That's how I look at it. You know, to end this discussion, though, on the other end, there's also a rumor that Xbox has a patent, not that they'll use the patent, that with the Kinect they can charge extra for movies and everything, supposedly. If there's two people watching a movie and another person comes in to watch the movie, they can, you know, say, well, if this person wants to watch the movie, they have to pay an extra fee. Which, once again, that's an invasion of privacy.
Yes, it is. Or if you're on Netflix and another person, you know, got your password or whatever, I mean, I feel like that's an invasion of privacy also. Because if you give another person the permission to use your Netflix, it should be okay, as long as it's getting paid, right?
In one sense, I agree with that. In another sense, I don't, because they're not making any money. I understand that business size. Just like on the used game market, the developers aren't making any money. So that's what's killing. That's why we have $500 million in Grand Theft Auto clones and everything else, and now a zillion zombie clones, because they just are looking at what's popular rather than, you know, taking a chance at something else because they don't know if they're going to make any money.
Exactly.
Right.
So, all right, we're going to say goodbye, even though we're going to stay on the air as long as they'll allow us to. So, CT Jags out.
See you later from Miss Chrissy.
And say goodbye, Poppy, even though we may not actually jump off.
All right. See y'all later.
All right. Well, we'll see if it allows us to continue or not. It looks like they upgraded their system. We'll see what's going on. Soon we're not going to have to deal with this. We'll have longer talk times anyway.
Yeah, pretty soon.
Okay.
We may get
instructions. Now it's telling us 10 seconds. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
If they knock us off, they knock us off. If they don't, then we'll continue talking.
Exactly.
So I'm not seeing where they're knocking us off as of yet. And we're not really abusing their privileges. You know, we're allowed to come on. And
right, we're not doing anything wrong.
We're going to stay on as long as we can, just like any radio would. Period. Okay, so back what I was saying, you know, there's pros and cons to both. And the thing that's bothering me with both parties, which is kind of getting a little political now in the sense of everybody's beating around the bush about what their policies are.
Right.
Instead of being outright and just saying, this is our policy, this is this, and this is that.
Deal with it.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. This is what, it might be a crazy question, but do you ever think they'll get together?
Well, I think the agenda could be, which people would think I'm absolutely crazy, but it makes a lot of sense. If once were to intentionally fail with Nintendo pretty much gone, I'm sorry.
Right.
Nintendo is just not. If they're not gone, they're more of, you know, in the background.
Yeah, the Wii is more for, it seems like, for the younger crowd.
I don't know.
I mean, from what I see from the games that I've played, they seem more for the younger crowd, and the Xbox and the PlayStation seem to be more upgraded or a, I don't want to say adult version.
Well,
but they're made for the teenagers and the adults.
The Wii U just doesn't have the power to, you know, compete with Xbox and
exactly, or the games.
Sony. But the whole thing is, if one were intentionally to fail, okay, that would give us one choice, basically.
Right.
I mean, you got the one with the lesser graphics, you can go that route. You can go the computer route, but then you have to upgrade this, upgrade that, upgrade this, upgrade
exactly.
that. It's ridiculous. Or you can go the OU or however it is, and that, you know, connects TV. But if I wanted a Nintendo graphics, I'd, you know, go pick up something else.
Exactly.
You know?
Go pick up a Nintendo if you want graphics.
Yeah, I'd go back to, you know, Nintendo and whatnot.
Right.
So if one were to intentionally fail, we would have no choice. And that could be the case.
And I think if something happened and for some reason, let's say PlayStation failed, I think Xbox would pick it up and they would get together and probably make a system that's just as good, you know. They'll put the PlayStation and the Xbox together or something.
No, one would back the other. That's what would happen.
Oh,
one would intentionally fail, work the deal with the other to stay alive, and would make it one and then back the other at the last moment.
Yeah. I mean, no offense,
right.
Like I said, to Sony or to Xbox. I'm just saying, just use them as an example.
Well, Microsoft, but yeah.
Oh, yeah, but still, they know what I mean.
I mean, that could be absolutely ridiculous and everything, but anything is possible.
Right.
Anything is possible.
Right. And I don't know, I guess it's just me because one is leaning towards gaming. I've seen some gaming on the PlayStation 4, and I think it's beautiful. You know, I understand Xbox is coming out with the Forza, but I don't think I would have promoted the Forza, you know.
Well, I mean, go ahead.
I don't think I would have promoted the Forza on the Xbox One, you know. I would have waited, came out with a better game than Forza, you know. That's just me.
Well, they did show the Quantum Break. They didn't show much of it, but they did show a little bit of it to Xbox credit. The issue, though, still remains is if you have a design, what are you scared of and why won't you tell people what's going on? And why are both companies after people are, you know, what do you call it, rioting or, you know, backlash off the Internet all of a sudden, you know, changing they're going to change their policies now, and they didn't say this before. It doesn't make any sense. Because evidently they're both going the same route. If they weren't, then one wouldn't say something or the other wouldn't say something.
Exactly. Right. I agree.
One may be quieter, but they're both going the same route. Otherwise, you know, there would be, you know, the heads of failure, and they really need each other to provide competition, unless that's not what they're after all.
Right. And I believe they still are trying to be in competition, but I believe one is just completely. I love the, don't get me wrong, I love the Connect, and I love what they're trying to do to it, you know. But you're going to need more than that Connect to compete with this PlayStation 4, I think.
Yeah, of course you need more. You definitely do. You definitely need to show a new Gears of War, which I don't think they're going to. But
I don't think they can.
Halo, they're new. Supposedly they're supposed to have a bunch of new IPs and whatnot. But if they're all Kinect-based, then ain't nobody going to even care, to be honest with you.
Exactly.
Kinect is a heck of a system if it comes to, like, we had this movie game that was fun to play.
Oh, yeah, where I put in the game where you actually were acting out movie parts. It was fun.
Yeah.
And then there was Kinect Adventures, and there was Kinect Sports, which were nice, and Kinect Animals, or Kinect Animals, where you get to, like, pet the animals. That's cool and whatnot.
That's cool,
but
I wasn't that crazy about it.
I never bought the Xbox for the Kinect, to be honest with you.
I liked the Kinect because we were able to talk to people from different states that we otherwise
wouldn't
be able to.
And I love what they did with Skype also, you know.
Yes, I love what they did with Skype, and I agree there. I love the fact that they got where you can, like, pinch in the screen and pinch out. I love that fact.
Yeah.
Factor.
Right.
I don't like the camera being on 24/7. I'm just not a fan of that.
Right.
I thought you said they weren't going to have the camera on 24/7.
As long as the Xbox is on, the camera has to be hooked up.
Oh, okay. Well,
right.
Camera's not, I mean, your Xbox is always on anyways. It's on just long enough for you to be playing a video game. So what are they going to see? They're going to see you playing a video game.
Yeah, or recording. But on the same token, even though, you know, PlayStation doesn't have where the camera has to be on 24/7, it does have where there's that button where you can record. And who knows if somebody's recording when you're not hitting that button. If it's built in there somewhere, you don't know what somebody's doing.
Right.
Exactly.
So, but I mean, I like what I see from, you know, the PS4. I like what I see from the Xbox One.
Well, you know what? Even with that recording with the PS4, what if, you know, it's used for people just to record, like, conversations with other players to get that person in trouble, just to get people in trouble? Oh, well, Inflate My Monkey said this, or Poppy Red Hunter did that, or blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? Just to cause trouble.
Yeah. Or Johnny Quest 5 said.
Yeah,
you know,
or Johnny Quest 5 said.
Yeah.
Said stuff. Started cussing at me or something, or even something just stupid, you know?
Yeah. I mean, once again, it becomes, is it an invasion of privacy, or is it, fair gaming?
Exactly, that's my point.
Right.
That's my exact point.
I mean, if the Kinect is used for, you know, to catch people that are modding and, knock people off with the rapid-fire controls and stuff that ruin a multiplayer game, then I'm all for it.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And that's the same thing with the eye. If the eye is used for that reason, then I'm all for it. But if it's used for other purposes and people could prove it, I'll throw it out the trash. That's just what I'll do.
Yeah.
And pick up the other one. I just will. I mean, I think that's the majority of people's opinions.
Well, we're keeping Xbox anyways, even when we
can
get the new one.
Yeah, exactly. And there's no reason to really switch up from the current console because they still got great games.
Exactly.
Right.
I mean,
they do.
Graphics alone is not going to change my mind. It's just not.
No.
Right.
So you have to show me stuff stellar, and I don't believe either are. Other than that, give us another topic to talk about real quick, man. Think of something. Anything bothering you?
No, it's nothing bothering me. It's just, I don't know, man. I'm trying to live. That's about it.
Yeah, that's everybody.
Yeah.
How's your dogs doing?
They crazy.
There you go. Talk about
they
favorite
are doing,
talk.
They are doing just fine.
That's good.
As a dog owner, what's your favorite part of having a dog?
Oh, man, the playing, fighting, it's fun. It's fun to watch them. I was watching them today, and you know, they play a lot, and they wrestle a lot, you know. And my littlest dog, he's a little chihuahua, and he jumped up on the bed. He got frustrated or something because he jumped up on the bed, and because they were wrestling, he jumped up on the bed. And he turned around, and when he turned around, he jumped straight off the bed onto the other dog's head. I thought it was real funny.
That is funny.
It felt like wrestling, you know what I mean? Like they were wrestling.
Oh, God, that's cute. Like they're being wrestlers.
Oh, that would be a great thing to, you know, put on a video camera and whatnot.
I know.
Yeah, it would.
Cute.
Yeah.
Well, that's like this morning, Jackson came, and he was laying on the bed with us, and, he goes right over towards Ray and lays right next to my honey, and it was so cute. He goes right. If I pull him away, he gets mad.
Yeah.
He like tries to scratch me and jump out of my arms.
You want to hear the weird thing, man? And I know I'm on live like radio and whatnot, but I don't care. You know, because people are more embarrassed than I get sometimes on things. But with the whole thing with a certain kind of animal, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Is there some animals out there that to let you know that they love you, they dance around in a circle and then pee on you?
Yep.
I'm kidding you.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm like, Jackson, really, today?
Yeah, he does it all the time, too.
Yeah.
It's like, leave me alone.
Except today he didn't do it.
So.
Yeah.
But
now, I understand where you're going at on that one because I think it was last week sometime. I was sitting there on the couch, and the little chihuahua, he jumps up on the couch, and he looks at me, and all of a sudden, I felt something warm. He was just looking at me, too. I said, you. And he peed on me. I said, really?
He was lifting his leg right on you.
But I mean, animals will do that to you. And sometimes they just do the wackiest stuff. Like the other day, I was looking at things, you know, talk about on the show and whatnot. And Jackson comes around. He does a happy dance. And then runs away. I thought it was the cutest thing.
Well, our friend had a German Shepherd, and this German Shepherd was such a good dog. And he knew whenever you were sad, he would just start running, and he just run into walls on purpose. This big old German Shepherd.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, he was so cute. Or he'd come down and put his head on your leg and look up at you real sad and just sit there the whole time with you.
Yeah, but when he wanted to play, he could scratch big time. I was wearing a hoodie, and he came up to, you know, grab me, and he put his arms in it.
Claws.
And it freaking started making scratch marks in me, even though I had a hoodie on. It was crazy.
But, and he didn't mean no harm. He just wanted to play.
Yeah, he just wanted to play. That's just.
That dog didn't have a mean bone. Well, he could. If he was protecting the family.
Yeah, you bet you. If he's protecting the family, he'd tear something up.
Yeah.
With quickness.
Yeah. Yeah, buddy.
But, I mean, animals are just, you know, the greatest thing.
Yes, they are, man. I love them.
You know, I love all animals. I'm not a big cat lover. I'm not going to hide that fact.
songs.
Right.
I just don't like them for one reason. When you're upset, and unlike dogs that will leave you alone and other animals, cats want to come up and curl next to you, and being a guy, you know as well as I do, I don't want to be bothered at that point.
Right.
Sure.
So.